Hi, my name is Justin. I'm a designer here at Axosoft, and I wanted to take a minute to talk a little bit about the concept of remotes in Git and how you can connect to them. So what is a remote? A remote is basically any repository that is not on your machine. If that repository is up on a service like GitHub, or if it is on a company server, that's considered a remote. And then any repository that's on your machine is a local repository. There are two different ways that you can add a remote. You can either clone a repository to your local machine, which will actually create the remote automatically, and then you can add a remote connection manually. So here I have an example of your laptop, or in this case, my laptop. And on my laptop, I have cloned a copy of this open source repository, which is GitHub's Electron. So up in the cloud, GitHub has a repository called Electron with one branch called Master. I clone that to my machine, and what it does is it creates a local copy of the branch that's on that repository, which is Master, and Git automatically sets up a connection, a remote connection, to that repository, and it names it Origin. So if you've ever seen Origin, that's where that's coming from. So down here in my remote section, I see the Origin remote, which is referring to GitHub's Electron up in the cloud, and it's one branch that it has. So now if I wanted to make changes to this master on my local machine, I can do that experiment without any risk of breaking anything. Then let's say I wanted to push those changes up to GitHub's Electron. I would actually push from my local to their version. If they were accepted, then those changes would get added. And then when I did a fetch, the changes from GitHub's master would come down and be represented in the link to the remote over here. That's cloning. The second way that you can do this is with adding, and adding will basically explicitly set another person's or some other remote or some other repository as a remote. In this example, Molly has created a fork of Electron, so she's working on her own thing, so she can add a feature to that. So on her machine, she has the local copy that she's cloned of her version of Electron. She's done some work on here with a feature, and she's pushed that feature up to her version right here. Now, I want to add Molly's remote so that I can collaborate with her on this feature. So instead of doing a clone, I would just do a git add, and git allows you to name that remote whatever you want, so it makes it easier to reference. So in this case, I've named it Molly, and now I can see that there are a master and a feature branch that are available to me. It doesn't automatically create local copies of those. I would have to manually copy that and make the change. But if I wanted to, now I could check out feature, do some work, and push it up, and it would push up to Molly's version of Electron. Once we've got everything figured out, if we wanted to submit this as a pull request to GitHub's Electron, then it would go from Molly Electron to GitHub Electron. And that's the basics of how you would add a remote, either with cloning or with adding. I hope it's super helpful, and thank you for watching.